Hi everyone, welcome back to my YouTube videos. In this video, I'm going to solve exercise 6.22 of the textbook, First Course in Probability. So in this problem, we assume that we have two random variables x and y described by the joint density function equal to x plus y for all x and y, both in the unit interval 0, 1. Three questions. First one, is it true that x and y are independent? Then we need to find the density function of x. And last question, what is the probability that x plus y is less than 1? So the function again is given by f of x, y equals x plus y for all x, y in the interval 0, 1, each in the interval 0, 1. Okay, so first question, is it the case that the two random variables x, capital Y with this joint density function are independent? The answer is no, because we saw that x and y are going to be independent if and only if the joint density function can be written as the product of a function of x and function of y. Here, it's clear that x plus y cannot be written as a product of a function of x and a function of y. So the two random variables are not independent. Next question, find the marginal, the first marginal, so the density function of x. Notice that the density function of x is the same as the density function of y. Why is that? Well, because clearly the function is symmetric in x and y, completely symmetric in x and y. So that means that x and y both have the same density function, but they are not independent, okay? So, to find the density function, we look at fx of little x. By definition, that's going to be, not by definition, but I should say that's more a properly. So, to find the density function, you look at the integral of the joint density function with respect to y. Okay, so integral, strictly speaking, from negative infinity to plus infinity of f of x, y, dy. Right now, I'm just writing the definition of the general definition of marginal, how you get the marginal from the joint density function. Then, in this case, because x and y should be in 0, 1, you can just rewrite this as the integral from 0 to 1 of x plus y dy. Okay, and that's clearly equal to xy plus y squared over 2 in the interval 0, 1 again. Okay, and so we get, so of course for y equals 0, that's 0, and then you end up with x plus 1 half. So here it's x plus 1 half. That's the density function of x. That's true for all little x in the interval 0, 1, and that's 0 outside. And similarly, the question is not asked, but again, by symmetry, the density function of y is f of y equals little y plus 1 half for all little y in the interval 0, 1, that's 0 outside. Okay, so that's by symmetry. Now, next question, we want to find the probability that x plus y is less than 1. So probability that x plus y is less than 1. Okay, so by definition of the joint density function, this type of the probability of this type of event involving two random variables is going to be the double integral of the joint density function on the domain where x plus y is less than 1, okay, in this case. So if I draw a picture to see what's going on, you have, let's say, x is here, y is here, we have the interval 0, 1, 0, 1. Here you have, so let's look at this first, like this condition, but replacing the less by an equal. So x plus y equals 1 would be, so particular solution would be 0, 1 or 1, 0. Okay, 0, 1, 1, 0 are particular solution. So along the line with equation x plus y equals 1, you must have this point and this point. Okay, but again, because that's a straight line, okay, that means that straight line with equation x plus y should be the one connecting those two points. So you get this. And this condition tells you that you are below this straight line. So that looks like this. Okay, so what we are doing basically here, to find this probability, the goal is to compute the integral of this function x plus y, but on this triangle, okay? And so if you think of the function, so x plus y is going to be basically a plane like that, that goes up like that, value 2 here, 1, 1, and going down to 0. And so if you cut it like that, the question is, what is the volume of this kind of pyramid here? That's what we are doing geometrically. So then to answer this question, so we look at integral, so double integral of x plus y, dx dy, it doesn't really matter in which order we integrate, because not only the function that we integrate f of x, y is symmetric in x and y, but also the event is defined by a condition that is symmetric in x and y. So it doesn't matter if we do dx dy or dy dx, the calculation not only is going to be of the level, the same level of difficulty, that's going to be exactly, in fact, the same calculation. So here, y is between 0 and 1 in general, and then we want this condition. So you can look at the picture or look at the equation. So if y is fixed, then x, so you can look at it here. So y fixed, then x should be less than 1 minus y, okay? So we look at the integral here in the middle from 0 to 1 minus y, okay? So 0 to 1 minus y. You can also see it from the picture, okay? If you fix a little y here, then if you look at this point here, then x should go from 0 to this point, that's 1 minus y, okay? So that's where this integral comes from. Then that's just basic calculation after to conclude. So that's integral from 0 to 1 of the antiderivative of this with respect to x, that gives you an x squared over 2 plus xy. Okay, you go from 0 to 1 minus y dy. Okay, then this is equal to integral from 0 to 1 of 1 minus y square divided by 2 plus 1 minus y times y. Okay, at 0 it's 0. So this, I'm going to force the parenthesis here, this dy, okay? Then, so that looks complicated, but that's just a polynomial with degree 2 with respect to y. So let me erase maybe all this and continue the calculation here. So we have that, so the starting point was this probability here, probability that x plus y is less than 1, x plus y less than 1. So we are at this point now, so that's equal to integral from 0 to 1. So if we extend this expression, what happens? So we have a here, looking at the constant term only, we are going to have a 1 half, and that's it. So we start with a 1 half. Okay? Then here we are going to have a minus 2y over 2, that's just a minus y, but that's simplified with the 1 times y here. That's if we look at the term with degree 1, then term with degree 2, we have a plus y squared over 2 here, okay? But then a minus y squared here, so that's going to give you a minus 1 half of minus 1/2 of y squared, so minus y squared over 2. Okay, so this dy. Okay, then we're almost done. Equals, so you can put the 1/2 outside, and then for the anti derivative, you have just a y minus y cube over 3. You go from 0 to 1, that gives you a 1/2 times 1 minus 1/3. 1 minus 1/3. That's 2/3 times 1/2, that's 1/3. So conclusion, the probability that x plus y is less than 1 is equal to 1/3.